There's a sentinel. No reason to kill that thing unless you just want the XP. Here's another one. Can we make it? What's past it anyway? Oh. I mean, it's something we can sell, but if we can't kill it, I'm just gonna restore and walk past it. Basically. Now, Milo can't do anything. Slow doesn't seem to work on these things. I doubt sleep would work either. Might as well save it for a heal. A low-level heal. No damage. Shakes off the attack. Milo collapses to the ground. Can you imagine if she takes him out? 1 point of damage. She did. Now what you have in here is a worn robe. Oh, yeah, it's gotta redraw. Alright. Okay, passing it by. It's not far from the stairs down, so maybe we can go get it, because there's a way we can, once we get near the end, there's a way for us to, go back there. Yeah, past him is a chest with 300 gold. Something might drop out of here. What's... No. Something might drop out of there? No good. What's down there? Or just loops around. So we go this way. This is the shorter way. Wouldn't let me turn there for a second. We are really close to the... Oh, crap. Okay. It's gonna explode and kill us. I guess we can't really run from this thing. I guess it doesn't blow up because we haven't done any damage to it. Damn it. Sad. Valkyries, deliver the remains of Inigo's party to the shrine. I summon forth the soul of Inigo. Yeah, no, I don't know. Is this thing gonna come bouncing down, or is that random? I just want to get to the stairs. We're so close. is where the statue was. I mean, these I can deal with. Maybe I could just try to see if it wouldn't blow us up. Oh! Salamanders! Those don't look like salamanders I know. Crimson flames blast forth from Salamander 1's jaws. Oh, crap. And Salamander 2's jaws, and Milo's dead. Wow. Let me try to run from those things. Is the RNG already decided now? Because we're fighting these at the same spot, aren't we? But last time we didn't run into them. Oh, jeez. Well, these are easier than the salamander things. Nice, Milo. Maybe we can silence that? No, that thing's hitting us with physical attacks. I'm talking about that ball thing, whatever the hell that is. Okay, back here. Oh, man. Those might be fixed encounters, those chrome ball things. I'm not sure. Ouch. Well, these things are screwing us up. All right, saving here. See if this thing. Yeah, it looks like it's either a fixed encounter or the RNG's already decided at the spot. Yeah, this is like a little like save scumming. 87 points, 81. She's Pyra has the most. Spells really go past armor, so. I can't even switch items because there's no space, otherwise I'd give probably Milo the fire staff. Alright, so. Oh, we have two of these. Angel wings, you get rid of one. I'll probably use. Yeah, I'll have to use one to get home, so we'll only have one. We have two. Two healer fruits. So this is as good as we can get. You're gonna save here. I'm gonna see if we can defeat this thing. As it is, with no magic. Any kind of items we can use? Other than the fire staff. You know, if I drop the other angel wing thing, we only need one. We can buy another one in town. I can give Milo the fire staff, and he can use it for attacks. Special attacks. We'll see if it does anything. And that's not what I want to do. I don't want to use it. One angel feather dropped. And then item give. I don't even know for sure if he can use it. I'm saving like this. Boom, boom, boom. Using it, okay. I don't think there's anything she can do. No. Reasonably sure that doesn't have any magical properties, so. Thirty-eight points of damage. I'm not sure we can stop the thing from blowing up on us, though. I wonder if as you use the thing, it depreciates in value, because we're going to sell it. Although maybe I shouldn't. Oh, she's dead. Nice, we got rid of it. Now we can't heal any points. I want to check to see what's down there. Who's got the angel feather? Before I save. Okay, he's got it. Alright, saving. I want to check down here really quick. Nothing. Something might jump out of there. We're so close, though. Gold thing. We're finding nothing somehow. Oh, Jesus. Well, at least the ones that are here are not very low on hit points. So far. We're gonna feel it without her helping us. Or at least Inigo's gonna feel it. We have no more healing items left, no more mana. If I was playing on an actual Genesis, I would not have made it this far. I'd have to grind for more levels. Get more gear, stuff like that. One more. Yay. Okay. I just want to check here. Oh, jeez. This isn't even worth it. There's nothing down there, right? Yeah, one down. Okay. Never mind that. Now this is the next dungeon. The next level. Really not gonna go here, but this triggers off something, so... Now we leave. Thank God. We'll come back with some cool equipment, I guess. Not going shopping just yet. ...40,000 gold pieces. 20 gold pieces, oh, because he's dead. Right, we gotta restore the other guy. Oh, we gotta come back. I kinda wasted... You know, we're... Let's restore him. I'm just curious if it'll be just 10, because the rest of us are at full. I sense the soul of Pyra somewhere above us. If you wish, I can bring Pyra back to life. Why should it even be up to me? Bring her back to life. 520 gold. Alright. Now I got 41,000 something gold. Pyra is ready to adventure once again. Sure. Yes. I will, and I do. Is he full? Does he bring him back? Oh, her back. He brings her back as full. Okay, good. We know, well, we still want to go in here to see if anyone has anything to say. Apparently not. Okay. We leave. And go to the castle. Been a while since we've been here. Oh, Zern. Who the hell are you? Majesty has been waiting for you. Waiting for you. He's been waiting for you. And when you talk to him, he says, I've been waiting for you. Oh. Inigo, you arrive at an opportune moment. Zern the Elder, who once taught Melville the mystic arts, is here right now. The story he told us, well, it's best you hear it from him. Inigo, listen well to the words of Zern. You guys are like clones. Oh, jeez. As you may have suspected, Melville, my former disciple, is Dark Soul. Did we suspect that? His lust for power led him to the dark reaches of the Labyrinth. The Labyrinth was built by the ancients to serve a twofold purpose. To seal in the darkness, and to raise a champion, should the need arise. I believe that Melville seeks to unleash the forces of darkness. Well, it's a good thing he changed his name to Dark Soul, because you really can't be... Tyrant, evil, magic, wizard, dark force guy with a word name like Melville? Here, take the two halves of this mystic medallion. Receive an item, medallion. The medallion can be used with any gold fountain within the labyrinth. Remember the fountain we passed right before the stairs? One half of the medallion is to be cast into the waters of the fountain. Using the other half will instantly return you to that fountain. To use the medallion with another gold fountain, get the other half back. Good luck, and may the medallion assist you in your quest. The medallion can be used with any gold fountain within the labyrinth. He says all this again. Dark Soul may be defeated with the Arms of Light. The Arms of Light are four items that can only be used by a true knight. We'll be finding those eventually. Now, more than ever, it is up to you to return me my daughter. That was more than ever, it was always up to me. It's hard to believe that our hated enemy was actually one of us. Melville is Dark Soul, and he was right here under our very noses. Curse Melville. I knew we shouldn't have trusted him. You did? And why did you do nothing about it? Let's see if anyone in the town has anything to say at this point. Inigo, there's someone here to see you. He said his name was Melville. Oh, crap. The guy is over there, sitting at the table. Oh, boy. Step right in. There's somebody here to see you. I don't be so happy about it. Oh, brother. Sir Inigo, there's something I wish to talk to you about. My name is Inigo Montoya. You stole my father. Prepare to die. Is something wrong? You seem hostile. I see you found out about me. Well, that makes it all the better because I have a proposal for you. Actually, it's more of an invitation. Join me. Join with the darkness and rule this land with me. No? Foolish child. It's a shame that this is but my image before you. I could have shown you what it means to wield true power. But I guess you'll have to find out the hard way. What happened? I feel funny. I remember a guy was here to see you. He's sitting over... That's strange. He's gone. Yeah. That was alarming. Sheesh. I wonder if there's any... if it's worth to get any items at this point. Just gonna save here and... I will be right back, guys. See if there's anything we want to get here. Okay. I have made my determination. I'm gonna buy a new weapon for Inigo, and a new weapon for Milo. I don't have any more mithril, otherwise I'd get some kind of mithril sword, which is would be pretty awesome, but at some point he offers us a free one, I don't know, but that's not yet. He's not doing it yet, so I guess we have to explore more of the next level first or something. So for now, which we can afford, Yours for the paltry sum of 20,000 gold pieces. You got a funny idea of what a paltry sum is. An excellent purchase. You won't regret it. Want to buy something else? Another weapon? I still have enough. The battle hammer. For Milo. Oh, nope. That's it. Because we need to get stronger. In both armor and weapons. This is the best lance in the game. It's got plus 100 versus the fire sword, which I do like. And that's right, the fire sword is a special ability, but I don't know if it's better any better than... If you use it too many times, it breaks anyway, so... I'm gonna end up selling the fire sword. Because here, our weapon factor goes from 195 to 235. Boom. So, and for Milo... Oh, what happened here? Unarmed? Okay. Battle Axe... 157? Oh, actually, no. I'm looking at the wrong thing. 117 up to 132. Boom. So, I'll be kicking some butt now. Selling the fire sword. I wonder if we get better prices from the merchant next door. I mean, I don't know one way or the other right now, so. So yeah, the battle axe we're selling, and the battle hammer is a new weapon. Nope. And nope. So we need a few things now. Another angel feather, I guess? Yeah, we used the last one, right? We didn't have to use any of our, you know, smelling salts this time. Oh, right, the fire staff. Should I keep it? I don't know. And if we keep it, it's gonna hamper our ability to pick up new items. Although we do have some space for four things. With the angel feather, it'll be three things. We might hold on to it, at least for now. I want to see what they say here about this stuff. What's him that has it? Yeah. Sun armor. It's a piece of equipment for knights. What's more, I feel it's blessed with power. It might have other uses. Yeah, it helps with fire resistance, actually. Which is good against all these things that... didn't mean to do that. Against all these things that blast blaze at us and stuff. Anyway, I'd like to see what they say about this stuff. This is a magic medallion. This should be used at a special fountain. Indeed. I mean, what he says is not surprising, but I find it interesting. Maybe I'm alone in that, but I don't know. This helps with magic resistance or something? It gets used up after 1 use, so... Hmm, too long for me and too heavy for Pyra. This is a knight's weapon. No special properties, etc. What about the mithril armor? Indigo or I can handle it. What's more, I feel it's blessed with power, might have other uses, etc. Battle hammer? This one's for me. I don't think you or a pirate can handle it. Assaults. This is definitely Papyra. What's more, it's pulsing with magic. This thing might break if it's used too much. We can she use it as a weapon, actually. I wouldn't have her use that over the Thorn Whip, no. Any one of us can use this. Alright. Get the magic back. Now that he left, actually. I wonder if they have anything new to say. If it isn't Inigo, have you found the princess yet? I heard that the court wizard was behind it all. Yep, and he was here too. Hi, remember that weird guy who was waiting for you? Well, it seems he had something to do with that mess at the castle. I heard about Dark Soul. Yes, me, you're biting off more than you can chew. I heard the Dark Soul was in here. What nerve. Is it true, good Inigo? Is Lord Melville the evil Dark Soul? Yes, indeed. I've been told that you are searching for the princess. I know much about the labyrinth, etc. You said that before. Edward is said to be well-versed in ancient lore. But I can't actually ask him anything. Well, I think I still need to buy that feather. I don't have it, right? Losing track of all the stuff I have to do. Use this in case our wizard is... I guess our wizard is no good. Like, dead, incapacitated, etc. I guess that's it. Wow. Okay. So that was level 3. Thanks so much for watching. Actually, the thing that stinks is that after we found the fountain, now we have the medallion. So I have to go all the way back through that level to get to that fountain. And when I'm there, I might as well grab those items, maybe. Oh, there's a 500 gold behind one of them. I might fight one of those sentinels and get that. And then we can, once we dip the half the medallion in there, we have to, then we can just fast track over there. The only bad thing is that whenever we want to go fast travel to another fountain, we have to get that half of the medallion out of the other fountain, take it with us, carry it with us, and put it in the other fountain. So, makes it interesting. We'll warp over there and take it out, I guess. And try to gamble that we can make it to the next fountain. Otherwise, then we have to go through everything again. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure. Thank you.